So if we start with a brief review of what you might have learned in a computer architecture class before starting to look into operating systems. This particular piece of code might seem relatively simple. We have a variable named A that is getting incremented, and then if A is not equal to 1, we're going to go ahead and add 2 to A and save it back into A. When we compile that program, it produces assembly code, which ends up then getting turned into machine code, which is located at particular addresses. So the human readable version of this would say that at location 00, then we have an instruction that says we're going to load into register 1 a variable called A, specifically the address of A. When we have loaded that program into memory from secondary storage, then we are able to schedule it to run on the CPU. It begins execution at the location of the first instruction in our sequence of machine code, and typically the CPU is going to execute sequentially, but sometimes gets to a point where it reaches a jump instruction. Jump instructions are special because one of the things that they do is change the order in which the code executes. So in this case, if the condition codes in the CPU state that there is a zero flag raised, or if the previous comparison resulted in equality being accurate, this will result in a jump to the instruction located at 0x20 rather than the instruction located at 0x18. So remember, if you're having trouble with this, you can brush up on how hexadecimal works and come back to this section.